We've already taken out of the pantry. Holy cow, I can't believe that all that stuff fit in this little tiny area. And stay tuned for more.
Probably 17, 18 years ago, when we were stationed overseas in Okinawa. During the move back to the States, the ears broke off, this tip of this ear and this ear. Anyway, the horse is gonna get a complete makeover. And I was trying to figure out how to fix this ear. I decided to go ahead and buy some oven bake clay and mold the ears. So for the tip of this ear right here, my granddaughter and I just decided to figure out what we thought was the right shape for it. We molded it and baked it. And then for the missing ear, we did the same type of thing. and it will need some sanding and stuff, but it's been baked, and once it's the horse's repainted, I'm hoping that it looks okay with its new ear job. Okay, stay tuned. Okay, the horse has been cleaned, prepped for painting. The ears have been kind of glued back on, the one I'm going to put on the horse, and we'll see how it turns out. Done with the blue coat. It's all one color. And I'll let that dry. Look at the ears. Not too bad from far away. We'll have to do some more sanding, I see. That's better than two broken ears, right, guy? So we've got them painted up pretty nice. Got all the areas covered. He will probably need a second coat. Okay, we've got this side. This is like three layers of whitewash, 2-to-1 paint, and then half and half.